We now have to face a situation that the refugees arriving here, if we help them, we're helping them to go into a prison.
I feel worried about all this happening because it's happened so quickly and nobody knows nothing.
We're all very anxious because we have no real contact now inside the camp. It's all managed by the authorities. It's the one thing they can do competently. They do fence as well. They do barbed wire very, very good. One of the big issues for the people in the camp is they're not being given any information. And as Umar, one of our friends inside the camp, said, this is what's killing us.
For 8 months with my team, with the women, I fix more about 200,000 meals. I am here, and maybe I can help again the people. The government, he doesn't say nothing. It's like a secret, you know? It's like, I don't know. But I hope to finished all this nice for all the people.
We now just have to be a little bit patient. We don't go home. MSF have said they're not going home. This is very important because we think the system's going to collapse, and yet again it means that the volunteers and activists and the NGOs are going to have to take a role in providing the support that's going to be needed.
Open the borders, please. For the people, for the children, a lot of children, open the borders, nothing else. It's like human.